Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, as you know, His Holiness Pope Leo XIII established and erected our Catholic Diocese of Belleville on January 7, 1887. That means that in January 2012, we will mark the 125th anniversary of the establishment of this Catholic Diocese. Looking forward to that celebration, we would like in a very special way to renew ourselves spiritually with prayer and works of service, to renew the very foundation of our faith so that we can be more faithful followers of Jesus Christ. Often when I visit the parishes for parish pastoral visitations or confirmation and other events, I encourage all of our people to continue with the priests, religious, the deacons, and the parish leaders of their parishes to learn their faith, to love their faith, and to live their faith. During this year of 2012, when we mark our 125th anniversary, one of the ways in which we hope to do that together is by participating in the dynamic program, Fanning the Flame. With the program, Fanning the Flame, we will be encouraging all of our parishes and small groups and all of those involved in religious education to focus in a special way on the United States Catholic Catechism for Adults. This catechism was developed by the bishops of the United States in a special way for the church in the United States. And it is divided up into themes that are so appropriate: the creed, the faith professed, the sacraments, the faith celebrated, Christian morality, the faith lived, and finally, but most importantly, prayer, the faith prayed. It is my hope that with the Fanning the Flame program, all of our parishes will develop small groups that will take up this catechism and read it, discuss it, pray about it in order to re-energize the faith in our diocese, a kind of a new Pentecost, if you will. As I said in my pastoral letter of 2006, we are His witnesses. We who are the Catholic Church in Southern Illinois are called to be witnesses to Jesus Christ by our baptism. Jesus Christ, who needs us. He needs our eyes to continue to see. He needs our ears to continue to hear. He needs our tongues to continue to speak. He needs our hands to continue to serve. And He needs our hearts to continue to love. This program is not just another program. It's really meant to be a dynamic activity that will give our priests, our parish life coordinators, our deacons, our religious, our lay catechists, our young adults, and everyone involved in our Christian communities the opportunity to really open their hearts to Christ, open their hearts to the Holy Spirit, open their hearts to the love of God. The image fanning the flame is so apt. When you think of a candle with a little flame on it, it's a beautiful sight, whether at a birthday or on a Christmas tree or a light shining in the darkness, a candle with a little light on it. But remember, the first time we see such a sight often is at baptism, when our parents are given the lighted candle, receive this flame, receive the light of Christ. And they're told to keep that light burning brightly until we meet Christ for all time in the eternal kingdom. And that fire of that candle, of course, can, of course, light a great fire. It can illuminate a whole room. It can be used to light other candles and illuminate every household in our diocese. But that same flame, of course, can be blown out very easily. Just a little drop of water or someone blowing it with their breath can extinguish that flame. Fanning the flame means remembering the importance of our faith and allowing nothing to extinguish that flame, but allowing it to burn brightly from the time of our baptism when we receive it through our experience of the great sacrament of the Eucharist and the sacrament of confirmation and the sacrament of Christian marriage, and to do so, of course, the sacrament of ordination as well, and to do so throughout the entire liturgical year as we see the candles lit on our altar Sunday after Sunday when we celebrate the great gift of the body and blood of Jesus Christ in the Eucharist. The most profound expression of this light, of course, is during the Easter season when on Holy Saturday in the Easter Vigil we light the great Easter candle. It's a sign of the light of Christ, reminding us Christ raised from the dead. And the Easter candle, of course, later on as we celebrate Pentecost, reminds us of the flames that come upon us by the gift of the Holy Spirit in the first Pentecost that gave birth to the church, and in the new Pentecost that happens in our own day. And of course, that same Easter candle is placed before the eminently gentle remains of our loved ones, when the dearest of the dear in our lives who have lived the Christian journey from God to God are brought back into the Catholic Church for the liturgy of Christian burial, and the Easter candle is placed above them, and it reminds us of Christ our light, the light of the world and the light to which we are all drawn, and the light of the kingdom of heaven to which we hope our loved ones who have died are destined to be received. And so fanning the flame is a wonderful opportunity, and I want to encourage every one of you to take the time to look at the resources that you will be receiving, to study them, to talk about them, and not to say you're too busy or your parish already has too many activities. Take advantage of it and study it, talk about it, make use of the resources so that throughout that year of 2012, as we mark our 125th anniversary as a diocese, as a Christian community, as a local church, under the leadership of our Holy Father, Pope Benedict XVI, each one of us, bishops, priests, deacons, sisters, lay people, children, young and old, each one of us will be renewed by the Holy Spirit, the bright flame of faith burning in our hearts in all we do and all we say, as we make every effort to truly, with the use of the United States Catechism for adults, to truly learn our faith, love our faith, and live our faith. Praise be Jesus Christ. May God bless all of you.